Just as you're starting to like Vim, it slaps you in the face.
Remember, we're helping you learn Linux.
So hello and welcome back to my channel. My name is Andrew Mallet and I am the Urban Penguin. Now I know I've recently done a series on looking at Vim, so 7 days and 7 videos. But one thing we didn't cover, and I've realised this week as I've been teaching a little bit of Vim on my Red Hat training, is that we do need to look at that problem we've probably all experienced when we go through onto the command line and realise that we didn't exit Vim properly last time and the file already has a swap file. Okay, we try and recover it. We go back in, it still says the swap file exists. We're stuck in that moment. Well, we're going to look at how we can release ourselves from that intolerable jail of the message, we've got a swap file. So here we are at the glorious command line. If we understand what we mean by this swap file and stuck in this moment. So let's go through and create ourselves a new file. So Vim file 1. It's a new file, so it doesn't have any content. We can hit I to insert, and then we can start typing away. So whatever takes our fancy, we can start typing. Now, once we're ready with this, we should be thinking about saving constantly, the same as in other operating systems. So escape, colon, and W will save that file. So you can see now we've saved it to disk. But we've also got a mechanism to be able to recover from a crash or something like that, an unexpected failure. So I would recommend, if you are writing code, to be saving quite regularly. But if I go through and hit the lowercase o to insert a new line, I can then start typing all of my code, whatever I need to type. Obviously it's just rubbish, but it gives for quick typing, and I haven't bothered saving. So all of this then has just been written through to a swap file. By emphasize that wording written through to a swap file, it has actually been saved to the swap file, but it's the cause of our problem. Now if this was a mistake, we might think that we can undo by using a control and Z. Other applications use a control and Z. So we do that and look what happens, something weird. We get this number 1 plus stopped. Vim file 1. Control and Z actually sends a signal through to our scheduler to stop CPU time for that process. So I might think, well, okay, just go through and edit the file again. But look at this. We then get saying we found a swap file and a process has this file open. We might think, oh, we'll just edit anyway. So we hit the E, but we're there to the last change. Anything we've made after the last change, we don't have. So we might be a bit worried now. Oh, we've lost all of our edits. Let's try again, though. If we go back in, edit the file, read the bottom. If we hit R for recover, we've read in then the swap file. Recovery is complete. So we can then go through, hit enter, and everything will look pretty good. So we might think, oh, well, that's okay. We're sweet. We've resolved our problem, and look at this, we've actually recovered to the point of failure. So this is actually a very, very nice feature. If the power goes out, we still got all of our changes. We haven't lost maybe 30 minutes of coding. Really fantastic feature. So at this point, we're probably quite happy. So we go through then escape, colon, and X to save and exit. And then we're probably happy that we can go in. Oh my God, we're stuck in that moment. How do I get out of this? Well, a couple of things. One is that there is a process that is still running that is holding that open. It tells me at the top of the screen, process ID 1597 is still running. Remember, we just stopped that process. So it's not taking processing time, but it's loaded in memory and it has a lock on our file. So that's what we want to work with. So let's go through and just hit the A for abort at the moment. With that done, we can then go through and use pgrep to search for processes running Vim within our own context. And we can see there we've got 1597. That was a process that was reported by Vim itself. So that is quite good. And as a standard user, I can be quite happy to run pkill. Be careful about running it as root. Pkill vim, because we're going to kill off all vim processes. As an ordinary user, I can only kill off my own processes. So now that process is... Oh my God, I'm still there. But the swap file is still there. Recovering doesn't resolve it. We can use vim minus r to recover, but it kind of tells us and says, well, look, yeah, everything is the same. And it just warns me that I need to delete the .swap file. So I can go through and look at this. Nothing is different. If I go in and edit the file again, it's going to warn me about that file. So vim minus r is just a shortcut to running the recovery. So again, I can go through and hit abort on this. I'm not going to do anything until we've deleted that swap file. So once we've recovered our data, we can get rid of our swap file, but we have to get rid of the swap file. So of course then, if we're a little bit new to Linux, we're going to run the ls command to look for the swap file, and we don't see it. Well, it's a .dot file, so we have to run ls minus a to see our hidden files. Let's just run that from the top of the screen. And we can see there that we've got the .dot file 1.swp. So we can remove it, rm.file1.swp, and you'll be thankful to know once we hit the big enter key on this that we're ready to go and we're released from this intolerable pain of the swap file being in existence. So we've been able to go through and list our swap file with the ls-a. We've recovered with the vim-r. And look at this, our file is up to date and we can get into our file without the warning. So yeah, you might quit out or crash out of Vim. Don't worry, all of your file changes will be in the swap file. We need to recover either from Vim minus R or using the recover from the menu. But once we're there, delete the swap file.
All that is left to say is thank you for watching. If you've enjoyed this, then you are probably sadder than I first thought. For more of this drivel, please subscribe, like and comment to @TheUrbanPenguin.